Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to Excellency Esports Light League. If you're just joining us, we just watched Degenerates Reform play it back into Redefy after a 10-0 deficit, taking the game after Adderall's excellent split from his Yorick play. I am your play-by-play caster, Zephyr, joined by the lovely Pwn star, Shibi, as my color. And we're hot in the draft, baby.
Yeah, Degenerates Reform standard bans. They're taking out the Nocturne. Looks like they're going to ban the Shen from last game. But it feels like Redefy, they know what they have to ban. They have to ban the Thresh. They have to ban the Yorick. But now they have the decision of either leaving the Tristana open, the Rell open, or the Seraphine open.
Yeah. Right? Those three picks are the big, crucial, key components of what makes Reformed really tick here. Because they're blue side, it matters that much more. Depending on what they first pick here, we'll have to see the response. And I know you had some thoughts there.
Yeah, it's as Degenerates actually bans the Seraphine away, unwilling to play it. So now Redefy has the ability to ban the Tristana or Rell. I don't know if Rell was necessarily a problem, but she was getting some massive engages into the mid game. But a character like Tristana is something Fox Zero is immensely comfortable on. This man, you know, if that guy gets Kai'Sa, Rell, or anything like that. So now Hecarim is, they take Hecarim.
They take Hecarim. They do have the power on their side. I will say Hot S'mores was not able to eep out a victory on the Hecarim last time around for Reformed. And while it is definitely a power play in the jungle, it hasn't done him much good. I will say in the regular season, we did see some power. So hopefully into these finals, maybe it'll wrap itself back around. He'll come through and we'll see the hard engage that makes S'mores tick. But unleashed on the response here, after the ban on that Tristana, like we said, are going to lock through that Kai'Sa to make sure that it doesn't find its way over here to Fox Zero now.
Yeah, and I expect a Rell here, unless Redefy is just really allergic to it. Kai'Sa Rell, such a strong lane, so good at just asserting dominance. And I think the Hecarim pick was just to take it away from Embiid as well. I mean, that man performed exceptionally well on Volibear. I can't even imagine if he gets a better jungler, right? So we'll see what they trade in respect. Redefy going down all the picks, going down the countdown. We'll see what they lock in for their second pick. They're actually going to take the Echo.
That's an Embiid favorite. He comes through and he absolutely played it here against Darkseid last week. And it showed the power, showed the rotation, and it's going to be just as aggressive, if not more, than what was that Volibear pick. It doesn't have that frontline advantage for engage, but it's definitely going to be looking to shut down some of these major carries given the chance. I like Reform's response, though, but I do think the Vayne is a little bit early into the pick of this draft. But they wrap it through with the Cho'Gath to give it a little bit more presence.
And I like the Vayne pick. It is a little early, but it, you know, I don't think Degenerates Reformed wants to get stuffed out of 80 carries again, right? I don't want to see Fox Zero on Varus. I want to see him on something that is a little bit more mobile, that can make a little bit more plays. But as the Anivia is led through, it feels like Redefy is getting a lot of their comfortable champions, right? Echo, Anivia, Kai'Sa,
100%.
You know, strong in the meta, some of them, but definitely just more comfortable and more comfort picks as we see. The Victor ban coming out for Redefy definitely was a problem for them.
100%. Crimbale came through, showed up finally towards the end there, and they did a great job funneling gold back onto the Victor to make him more of an apparent danger. And so I definitely think that they're definitely stunting kind of the plays here on the side of Crimbale, but he still has champs like Sylas that he plays through available. Orianna is still on the map if he wants to go something more teamfight oriented, so we'll wait and see. But definitely good bans from them to start off with. It's going to be hard either way playing into the Anivia. This is one of Cutekin's best champions that he likes to run with on his side. And to also pair through now with that Rell ban, make sure that the usual hard aggressive support that you find on the Flute Loops doesn't make its way through.
The Malphite ban coming through as well with the Karma, something that Redefy's top lane plays quite a bit of. I mean, the Karma can be flexed in multiple roles, support and top in this case. And I really want to see where Degenerates Reform kind of pull these next two picks out, right? They have to kind of, you know, they'll get at least one counter pick. They'll definitely have the counter pick in the mid lane as we see the Kennen top.
That'll be interesting. They're looking to play that hard then towards the team fight side.
Mm-hmm. And it looks like that's where Redefy was really getting a lot of their advantages, right? They weren't losing the 4v5s or the 5v5s in this case until very later on, where they were mispositioning and they were getting kind of anxious. It felt like, you know, they were firmly in the driver's seat for most of the game up until Degenerates Reform started splitting. And obviously Cho'Gath is no Yorick, right? But
there it is. Called it. Yeah. Sylas on the Crimbale.
And Sylas has a lot of good ultimates to steal from, right? Kennens, Echoes, even Kai'Sa to an extent, right? Kennens' ultimate is so good, right? Echo is also very good. Echo's ultimate is very good. Sylas can do his full rotation, dive in really quickly and get everything out, and then R back and kind of just do the whole thing, rinse, repeat once more. And Silas is, you know, going to do a lot of damage. You see the Alistar pick maybe coming in from Degenerate's front. That is something that Flute Loops does play. We're going to look to see if he can get a lot of roams off on this champion. Vayne Alistar is an interesting lane. I don't know how it's going to match up with Kai'Sa and whatever the Redefy support picks here. I'm expecting maybe a Leona or maybe possibly a Lulu even. I mean, we'll see what's left on the table.
To consistently enable Kai'Sa in some way into these late game team fights. He did a great job taking out Karma, which is a usual suspect here for Lemon Soda.
Oh my, that's a guy I haven't seen in a while.
One of my favorites, personally. I love watching Cosmic Radiance and how you can play around it, but this really dissuades a lot of the hard aggression that might come through here from Reform, because they've drafted themselves a hard pick comp. They're going to be trying to lock down and get on top of these carries, and the fact that they have the Cosmic Radiance to play around now with that Taric and just Taric as a whole, it's going to bode some different types of strategies now.
So I feel that what Redefy's comp is, it's a bit fractured, right? Because Kai'Sa wants to go in, Ekko wants to go in, Kennen wants to go in, but you know, Anivia is more of that hang back kind of, you know, control the space, control it with the ultimate, control it with the wall.
He'll come in afterwards. All right, Chibi, what will happen is all really hard engage. You'll see the Glacial Maelstrom and all that. And then he'll pull down the Blizzard. He'll throw it down and be like, hey, y'all, good engage.
Yeah,
and as they're running away, he throws the wall down.
Yeah, it throws the wall away. I mean, really, it's going to be on Degenerate's form to play around this Taric ultimate. Taric ultimate did get nerfed quite a bit back then. I believe its cooldown is almost, 2 to 3 minutes. So that first ultimate timing is, if they can play around it, if Degenerate's form can feint the engage, right? Degenerate's forms, I expect them to, you know, they have multiple engage options. They have the Unstoppable Force, they have the Alistar Headbutt, they even have the Silas and Cho'Gath Rupture and E from Silas. So if they can just not commit everything to the engage and bait or force the Taric ultimate out, back off, re-engage, it feels like Degenerate's Reform can be in the driver's seats of these fights, but it's all on to Redefy to see if they can answer back. You know, a Taric ult with a Kennen on it is nigh unstoppable, and it's so annoying to try to kill, right? So we'll see how well these Taric ultimates are placed, if you can get these 4 to 5 man Cosmic Radiances. And we'll really see if Degenerate's Reformed can kind of get these faint engages, kind of like the stick and move, you know, float like a butterfly, sting like a bee kind of engages, where they can bait some stuff out and kind of faint and get the Taric ult out, right?
Right, absolutely. And it's going to be a major key component, but at the same time, they have a lot of great windows to play around. You know, the Chrono Break on top of the Glacial Maelstrom into the Glacial that's always going to be on top of it. It's going to be a lot of lockdown potential on top of just reorienting most of these major team fights. And it's not to say Degenerate's Reform doesn't have an adequate response, but it's definitely going to be something hard to play into if they don't find an aggressive lead that they want. I will say, I am curious. Let's go back. Let's look at that win condition in the bye lane. What's your opinions this time? Vayne on the Fox Zero Man himself versus Kai'Sa coming through here for LSD Love.
So usually the Vayne is picked into the Kai'Sa because the Vayne can start scaling a little bit better than Kai'Sa once she gets those three items. When she goes, like, you know, she has a lot of itemization choices. She can go Kraken Slayer. She can go, I'm blanking out on the name, the Shield Bow. She can go Shield Bow. She can go for the PD, she can go for these LDR or the Lure Dominix, and she starts hitting like a truck, right, with silver bolts. While Kai'Sa on the island is more burst orientated, she's gonna have that early to mid game for sure. But if this game goes as long as the last one, expect Vayne to kind of start picking up a lot of the slack on the team, getting a lot of this damage down. I mean, she's gonna start, you know, three shotting a lot of these squishier carries. And you know, we know Fox Zero is no slouch. His positioning was immaculate on Varus. I can't wait to see these I am Gosu style Vayne plays that we're about to see, you know, 1v3, 1v4, rolling in, getting all these condemns down. And really, it's going to be really interesting to see how she navigates these fights.
Oh, 100%. I will say Foxer has shown us time and time again that he does have the skill potential to really eep out and rotate these fights when made appropriate. So big hopes on him there. And it definitely is one of his more advantageous champions to play around. So I definitely think it's going to be an uphill battle here for LSD Love. But he has drafted himself quite a bit of safety, whether it be playing around his team or just the general Kai'Sa pick as a whole. But that's not to say Fox isn't just absolutely nutty.
Yeah, and so the top lane matchup is, I'm looking at, honestly, as the marquee matchup. And it's weird for me to say that, but I think the Adderall versus Danny Phantom lane, specifically in this one, Kennen will have to exert a lot of pressure. Because at one point in the lane, Cho'Gath will just be able to absorb all the damage that Kennen gives and will just be able to push him out and shove him out. And Kennen will be looking to get forced onto these team fights, right? So we're going to see how much pressure that Danny Phantom can exert onto the top lane. We'll see that Hotsmores is on a better jungler now. He's not on the Jarvan. He's on something a bit more faster, a bit more stronger, and just a better overall jungler than the Ekko, as, you know, pound for pound junglers go. So we're going to see if even Adderall gets some attention in the top lane, because they kind of left him alone last game.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. And I think that's not something that can happen this time again. You can't leave him alone. That's exactly what he wants to do. The whole point of Adderall is being left alone.
Yeah, and how do you envision this mid matchup going? Do you think Krimvale will be able to, you know, one of his better champions, I think he's performs much better on the Sylas than a lot of his other champions, going against the Cute Kitten and Nivea? I mean, what do you think is going to happen in this lane? Is it going to be a wash? Is it going to be kills? It relies
on Hotsmores, Shibby. I mean, I don't think we're going to see Krimvale really get on top of Cute Kitten when he needs to, right? At least not until mid to late game. That's when the Sylas really shines. I want to see him sustain through this lane and play around, hopefully, Hotsmores if he gets a chance. But Gon has shown that he's going to be there probably first, a bit more proactive. He's going to be enabling it. And Krimvale needs to make sure that he definitely stays within the game's range and doesn't lose it too early, right? Like we saw last time around, he definitely had to wrap back around the victor. And while he did, it'd be a lot nicer if he was able to just kind of eep out a bit more even towards the mid lane. But come mid game, I see so much more advantage for Krimvale on this Sylas than I do for Cute Kitten on the Anivia, right? While the lockdown potential is there for Kitten, Krimvale is going to be playing around what you give him. It's going to be rough.
Yeah, and I expect a lot of this attention to go down from Hotsmores into the bot lane. Beautiful gank setup with the Alistar. Taric, not the most mobile of champions. So one misstep, Alistar headbutt, pulverize into the E, into the Vayne Condemn, and that man is just dead, right? So maybe they'll look to actually try to get Fox Zero ahead this time. Fox Zero going, I believe he went 1-4 or something crazy, right? The bot lane went 2-12 last game and they won. Definitely going to look to change that. But we're going to head into a short break as we get into the spectator delay. Stick around for game two. Game one was a banger. You already know this one's going to be amazing.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to the Excellency Light League. If you're just joining us, we are coming off of an insane victory from Degenerates Reform, taking a bit of a split into a massive kind of wipe as the Nexus falls in the face of Redefy, who held a lead for so long. I am your play-by-play caster, Zephyr, joined by the lovely Pwnstar Shibby as my color.
And really an astonishing game one ending, as now we might see some cheese on the side of Redefy Esports. It looks like they're expecting some sort of invade, but that's not going to happen. Degenerates Reform just going for the standard 5-point defense. Maybe may try to get some wards down in one of the Raptors or something like that, but not really anything. Just stacking this bush, maybe hoping for something, hoping for some cheese. Don't worry, guys. This time, Danny Phantom did buy some items, so he's not at a disadvantage level one, but... You
maybe
know,
that's what started it. You know what? We never discussed that, but maybe that's the truth. Maybe it all started there. Danny Phantom didn't have items for the first 3 minutes. And that's what really led to the victory here for Adderall.
Yeah, I mean, Yorick got so many items, so much CS uncontested, right? And that's how he was able to split push the game to a victory. Maybe if he had items, maybe he would have a little bit of less gold, wouldn't have that split pushing power, as we see. Pretty standard jungle starts. Hecarim going for his blue, Hecarim going for his red. They're probably going to meet up at the top scuttle. I would say Hecarim's favorite, but it really depends on who gets prio in both mid lane and top lane.
Absolutely. And now they're going to continue to push this one out. I'm curious to see. This is a reverse start, by the way, from the side of both these junglers from Gon and S'mores. And it kind of goes key in key with you discussed on the marquee matchup. Last time we said, you said it was bot lane and they started top and rotated bot. This time you say it's top and what do we see?
Yeah, and you know, what do you see there, Zephyr, in the top lane? Let me look at the rune choices really quickly. What do you see up there? You see something interesting?
Oh, for what team? Sorry, I'm just not gonna. I don't see anything interesting per se. I'm just gonna ghost the subject.
I see you're gonna ghost the subject, right? It looks like Danny Phantom has all the runes available to him at once. He's a master of none, a jack of all trades with that Omni Stone. I would have loved to see something else. Maybe that's the meta. I don't play a lot of Kennen. It sounds good in theory as we see some aggression in the bot lane.
No, I mean, nothing crazy. It's just a small trade. Don't worry.
Kennen is one of those champions that looks like he can get the most use out of all of the runes, though. Can get really good use out of Hail of Blades. Can get some pretty decent usage out of Predator if he can get it. The engage off. I mean,
Q-Kitten under turret, taken through. Bit of a surprise on the flip there from direct to camera, but either way, Egg is down.
Egg is down. Unfortunately, they could not make any scrambled eggs out of that. But yeah, you know, I think Kennen can get a lot of use out of this Omni Stone, a lot of the runes available to him, the phase rush, the comet, everything like that. I mean, he's one of the very few champions that can get a lot of value out of it. So we'll be interesting to see what he can do with this Omni Stone. I mean, if I don't know what rune I'm getting, then Adderall can't play around what rune is going to happen. So we'll be really interested to see how he pilots this in the top lane. But yeah, that flash going out for Anivia. Same thing. I feel like that happened again. You know, last time Hotsmores got the flash out from Cute Kitten, but wasn't able to really capitalize on it with Crimveil. Crimveil on a bit more of an engaged champion can CC him up a little bit more. So we'll see if he can use that TP or that flash advantage to himself as he gets this crab in the top lane. Right. And we just see Echo backing. I mean, he's not even going for the crab. He just went for the 5 camp clear, not going for his Grom. If he was going to back at that point, I would have loved to see him more of a full clear just because he can reset his camps, get that level 6 a little bit faster, and look to impact the map a little bit more. But Hecarim looking in the top lane should just go down to bottom crab, I think. See if he can contest it. I mean, they do know that it's there.
Right. I don't know. A little bit of slow pacing, I would say, from the junglers. I like to see them being a bit more aggressive. And Hotsmores is trying his best, but good on Phantom to really start the aggression and making sure that he has that ward up and not going to be able to prevent that. So I guess not just us. They also knew it was the marquee matchup for themselves. So they prevent that one out. But now Crimveil finds Gon here deep into the side. He's looking for some sort of gauge, but the Dazzle doesn't find its way into a stun.
Man, Hecarim, come on. Your team's fighting for that bottom crab. Screw the Gromp. Go down there and secure the scuttle, my brother. That gives way more XP. I mean, denying it from Echo is all good and dandy, but you need to give that to your jungler. This guy's just paying more and more attention. He's going for that Raptor invade. Man, this guy just does not care. As we see a small pause, but we're going to be back into it. No big deal. But, you know, good steal, but Echo's going to get this crab. Would have loved to see Hotspurs go for it. I mean, he's going for the Raptor deny, which is definitely pretty good. I mean, Echo's not going to have a lot to do once he gets to his top side after he clears his Wolves, as we see Hecarim maybe
ask me something. So this game's taking a bit more of a slower pace here, and no one's really kind of putting pedal to the metal as of yet. Who wins this one out in terms of just the farm kind of matchup, you know, letting the game slide towards mid to late?
I feel like Cho'Gath and Vayne just, you know, each of them respectively, Cho'Gath just gets harder and harder to kill. He might be going for that Everfrost build. He does have the amplifying tone, but even if he goes Everfrost, he can go the, you know, Dead Man's, the Spirit Visage, whatever he wants, and he'll just get insanely tanky, and nobody really has a crazy amount of HP shred. Anivia will be going Liandry's most likely, so that's kind of all you have. Kai'Sa probably won't be going. We'll see if she goes Kraken. She might opt in for the Immortal Shield Bow for a little bit more survivability, or might opt in for the Gale Force just to be a little bit more mobile to dodge out the Hecarim engage. So a lot of choices. We'll see what she goes, but I feel like Vayne and Cho'Gath just kind of outscale, you know, the Kai'Sa, the Kennen. I mean, Echo can do a lot of damage, but if this Hecarim goes tank, he's going to be another person to deal with, because Hecarim's one of those characters that goes full tank and still just runs into your carries and does like half their health.
Very true. So we'll have to wait and see. Definitely a little bit slower on the pace as a whole, but it's the same thing as usual. Degenerates Reform take that first Drake, put it on their belt. It's no crazy surprise there. I feel like that's the, if they didn't take first Drake, I feel like something wrong would happen. And sadly, you know, last semifinals, they were getting punished for it. This time, not so much. But speaking of punishment, punishment onto Adderall here. That Glacial Maelstrom is going to do some work. And the double flash double is what's going to secure that kill. Bit of an interesting move on that side of things. But still, we're into a bit of a pause. Once again, we can discuss that one out. Maybe need be.
Yeah, and do you think they should have committed the double flash there? I feel like giving the kill to Echo and getting him that Dark Harvest stack is probably better. He only really needed a flash. I don't think Danny Phantom needed to burn his flash.
I don't think anyone needed to flash, personally. I feel like you have a lot of potential to speed up and get on top of what is Adderall. No one's there for the response on the immediacy. So he can't run back towards turret. You already have that advantage on your belt. And if he does, it's one quick cooldown from either Danny or Gon, you know, in the next 10 to 5 seconds, and they can even throw in the wave pretty quickly, and suddenly, you know, there's no need for the flash. But hey, they're looking to secure, they're looking to get it done, they're looking to get it rolling for themselves here on Redefy, and I think one flash is necessary if need be. You know, maybe two is a bit much, who knows, but still they find the kill. All right,
I mean, that's
all that matters, baby.
Cho'Gath still has his flash, so now this gives him a little bit of kill opportunity onto Danny Phantom. If he can kind of W and Q him in the right way, get that feast off like you mentioned. And now, I mean, Echo getting the kill, very good. Gets that Dark Seal stack as we're getting out of the pause right now. You know, very good start for MB Gon. We've seen this before, Zephyr. MB Gon impacting the map, getting the jungle start. But now, let's see if they can translate this huge lead. He's on more of a carry. He's not on the Volley Bear, who's a lot tankier. You know, he'll be able to dish out a lot more damage. If he does get these 5-6 kills in the early game like he did last game, this Echo's going to be one-shotting the Vayne left and right.
Right. And that's the hope here. MB Gon is that aggressive kind of high damage oriented assassin carry when he plays the Echo. And while we haven't quite seen it yet, maybe now we will too, as he goes for a return gank here on Adderall. Once again, pushed so far forward. Doesn't quite find the stun when he needs to. And there is no Glacial Maelstrom to play this one back, but he's running into the alcove and there's not much to play around here. Can't even find what he wants when it comes to the feast stack. MB Gon, another kill.
And I feel like Sylas had an opportunity to TP up there. You know, Anivia's TP was down. If he TP'd up, could have, you know, Cho'Gath was playing and biding time. I think they might have gotten the double kill onto MB Gon and Danny Phantom. Really ambitious play from Adderall. Does the classic solo queue, teleport back to lane and dies. So he's going to miss out on a lot of CS in this top wave. Going to miss out on a lot of XP as well. Danny Phantom level 7 to Adderall's level 6. And it's only going to, that XP gap is only going to, you know, increase as the game goes on. Danny Phantom still has his TP up, can get the TP Maelstrom, like you mentioned, going for the, actually going to the futures market as well. 2,500, you know, he's 400 gold up on Cho'Gath right now. Echo, a pretty sizable gold lead onto the Hecarim, but really we haven't seen Hecarim do much. I feel like he always does, gets the flash off of mid and then just kind of disappears for the rest of the game.
Yeah. And honestly, that's got to change personally, because I feel like that's one of the biggest deciding factors that gives way for Redefy in this early game. The fact that they don't play around the jungle from Degenerate's Reform, they get the advantage onto Embiidon instead. And as a result, you see a lot of things fall through, whether it be on Adderall or Crimvale or this bot lane, right?
Yeah, it looks like this bot lane is kind of just a farm fest. And if you leave it to that device, I think Fox Zero is going to start scaling up more. But yeah, I want to harp on like what... I don't know if it's Degenerate's Reform necessarily not playing around their jungler, or if Hotsmores is just not, you know, willing to apply a pressure, right? Like, he's definitely willing to burn the flash, but then after that, he's just, as we see, jungle.
Yeah, Hotsmores, a little bit of the fight there. Q-Kitten is coming through over the wall. Can he find stun? Not quite. They aren't going to be able to launch on that one. It wasn't able to see quite who actually picked up the raptor, but hide your hair. The chicken is chicken. No big deal.
Yeah, as I was, you know, saying earlier, it just feels like Hotsmores is trying to look for these farm leads, look for these full clear leads, not looking to get a gank off onto the mid lane. I think there's multiple moments where, you know, Anivia's egg and flash were down. I mean, if you're level 6, you just immediately are into that. Silas will be able to follow up almost immediately, so I would have wished there would have been a little bit more pressure into this mid lane, but it looks like they could go for this bot lane dive, and it is Taric Kai'Sa, so Taric can kind of, you know, use the Radiant, use his ultimate, get the invulnerability out. So we're going to be looking to see where this Hecarim ult is going to be going. His second one, actually. He's his first one to get out from that top lane fight. As we see, more attention into Adderall.
Well, but this time a teleport to address it as well. Adderall is low, but a good silence to prevent it from Danny Phantom. He throws down that Glacial Maelstrom, but the response, and Crimvale with the steal and hijack gets it out just as quickly. Adderall positioning with that first kill up is gone, is looking lower and lower. Ooh, after a good
chain is clean.
Crimvale, fantastic rotation.
Yeah, and just as I said it, like, yeah, he should have TP'd in that last fight, uses his TP, has the last chapter, has the Lucidity Boots, is able to predict the E from Echo and secure two kills in the top lane, one for Adderall and one for Crimvale. They must be happy. As we see another pause, you know, having some lag and connection issues in this game. It's unfortunate, but really good play by Crimvale, good map awareness. His TP is going to be down for a little bit. LFQ Kitten will have the TP advantage. And so Dragon is coming up in 40 seconds. So what do you expect to happen in this ensuing fight that we both know is coming?
Well, personally, if I had to guess, Adderall's not going to move. Or maybe he will. He wants those stacks potential. But either way, I'm not expecting much from that there. But they do have the pressure in their favor when it comes to the side of Crimvale. But Gon is still a powerhouse to be reckoned with. And if he does posture out and find a good pick early onto whether it be Fox Zero or Crimvale combined with some kind of lockdown potential, suddenly Redefy looks really good onto this Drake. Otherwise, I would say Reformed has it quite literally in the bag. It's too hard to posture against Flute Loops. And the only saving grace probably would be the Cosmic Radiance if they play into it.
Yeah, so it's going to be on Degenerate's Reform to, you know, like I said, feint the engage, bait it out. Maybe look for like a Ghost E and then, you know, force Lemon Soda to like ultimate early. But, you know, Lemon Soda is one of the top tier supports in the Light League. And I don't think he's just going to, you know, use his ultimate for no reason. He's going to use it at perfect timing. He's not a scared, you know, he's not scared. He's going to be like, okay, you know what? You can live. Now I need to use it.
All right. Well, all that being said, though, we're going to be going to a little bit of a break. As we get everything resynced back up, we're having a little bit of issues with all these pauses coming through. I want to make sure that we bring you the best production possible. So we'll be with you just shortly. Stick around. All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Excellency Light League. We're bringing it to you hot and quick here, and hopefully that pause didn't dissuade you from the entertainment that we've got going here. Hotsmore's immediately able to pick up this Rift Herald, but he's in the face of Cute, and Danny Phantom pushes it back there. Can Phantom find the slow when he needs to? Gon's also on the chase, but the horse is a quick. Lemon Soda's there as well. Gon can't dive. He is out of there.
And he's gone with the wind. He's out of there, pushes the ghost, gets the, I think, phase rush proc as well. And really, Degenerates Reform putting some early pressure, getting these, Rift Heralds that we were talking about in their last series, not really prioritizing at all. Giving up the Infernal Dragon, you know, isn't the best look here, but I think the gold that's going to come out in the side of this Rift Herald is going to be immensely more valuable as we see Silas go in and flash out. Beautiful.
Maybe some miscommunication there on the steel kind of potential, and... they want to Adderall possibly to rotate down and play off it, but he didn't even have Feast available. So I think some Windows mistiming as a whole there from Reform. But hey, it's one Drake. It's just the Infernal. They're going to be now playing into a full Ocean Drake stack here, hopefully.
Oh, man. Oh.
Not quite the Headbutt Pulverize we're used to, but you know what? It works. And now Crimvale in the mid lane. Glacial Maelstrom playing back onto him here. He does have that advantage, but he doesn't quite find the chain that he needs on the Cube Kitten. He's going to be punished as a result as Phantom runs him under turret. Bit of a shame there. Bit of miss on that micro.
Uh-oh.
Hotsmore's response, though. He finds an immediate kill onto Phantom. Bit too far deep into that jungle on that back. So, you know, it's one for one at least.
Would have loved to see him start just running down the river. He had Echo in the river. Decided to just back right in their jungle. Doesn't know where Hotsmores is. And really, now this buff transfer just keeps getting consistently transferred back and forth. I think this double buff has been alive for almost 4 minutes now. Was on the side of Echo, then went to Crimvale, then went now back to Hotsmores. So we'll see, you know, if it gets transferred a little bit more. As we see Hotsmores being a little bit more proactive. Is 1-0, you know. Better than being 0-0-0 last game and not really getting much done. Has the chem tank available. Can now run people down with the quickness as we see, you know, a bit more vision control on the side of Redefy, having complete control of that river pretty much for the dragon and also having a pink in the top side.
Absolutely. So now I think a bit of good posturing here, but in a difference to game, Hotsmore's, good thing he's Hecarim or else that would have been looking a lot worse. Personally, in comparison to game one, Redefy had a lot of great pacing to start out with the first 10 minutes here, and it drawed them to an advantage lead that they played off of for the next 10 afterwards into the 20-minute phase, and that's where they took a lot of their assumed victory. That isn't here this time.
Yeah, actually, Degenerates Reform has about a small, you know, 2k gold lead. Not a lot, but... unfortunate that Hecarim or Hotsmores couldn't use the Rift Herald before the 14 minutes, so now there's no plating to be had. So hopefully this Rift Herald can be used to at least take the first tower of the game. And really, I like the Everfrost build from Cho'Gath. Redefy has a... Oh, as we see some fighting.
There is the teleport to come through here from Phantom, but he's not going to be playing off it because they have that ward up. They know the vision. What's the deal? And now... The worst thing you can do is leave Adderall alone in the top lane. I don't even know if he's able to do it 14 minutes right now, but it's definitely not what you ever want to see.
Yeah, this man will push towers if given the opportunity. We don't know if he went into the green tree to get the Demolisher proc onto the turret. He does have the unsealed spellbook, so we'll see if he can actually get Demolisher, so if he can actually push as quick as he can. I mean, it looks like the Rift Herald was also used in the top lane, so they definitely want this turret, and they definitely want to get this first turret gold.
Ooh, good knockup boot loops here. He's able to push back, but Love uses that killer instinct to make sure, but the follow-through from On the Hunt. Can they find the silver boats? Not quite. The response, though, won't come through. But that's just a showmanship of the great performance from Fox Hero that might get punched out by Gon and Cutekin's rotation, but not quite. There's that teleport there from Adderall.
Oh, man, that's not a sentence I hear too often. A teleport coming into the bot lane for Adderall. Securing his team, making sure his team's alive, but he did get the turret top lane. So he said, you know what? I got the turret top lane. I got my objective. I'll throw you guys a teleport now.
It's funny because he teleports but doesn't find anything. Now Crimvale super deep into this jungle here, going to be forced to steal the hijacked Chrono Break. Ooh, big flash from Gon. Make sure you get secure, but Flute Loops in the Adderall rotation forces Gon to use that Chrono Break to retreat out of this fight. So no one goes down, but a lot of safety windows.
Yeah, everybody's coming now pretty bruised and battered. Crimvale lucky to get that Echo ultimate, like I mentioned. Such a good ultimate to have. Was able to get out with the Blast Plant, with a little bit of help from Alistar and Adderall coming in. And it looks like this game, you know, it's gold lead is a bit, ballooning in the favor of Degeneracy Farm. Was once a 2k gold lead, now a 3k. Vayne, you know, scaling up, getting that Kraken Slayer. Both ADs have the Kraken Slayer. Two Everfrosts on the side of Degeneracy Reform, really countering this kind of all-in heavy comp that they have with the Echo, with the Kennen, with the Kai'Sa, can kind of look to freeze them in place and get a lot of the CC down. And just so much follow-up on the Alistar Headbutt Pulverize combo as well, right? So we'll be looking to see what Flute Loops can do on this Alistar, if he can get some crazy flanks. This dragon's coming up, and it's Ocean Soul.
Is the Ocean Soul available for them, but not quite yet? We're still, you know, like 15 plus minutes out or even more.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think no, I'm saying
Ocean Soul will be really good on the side of Degeneracy Reformed, right? That Cho'Gath and that Hot S'mores Hecarim just getting super tanky as we see. Oh, a rupture.
Good play here. Oh, good pullback on the Floops. And we talk about that cooldown on the Cosmic Radiance, and that's where you would have really wanted it. And sadly, it doesn't come through. So, not quite the feast that we want from Adderall there. He's going to be looking to expend them on the Drake, of course, to secure that one. There it comes. Boom, bam, bop. Getting himself another stack on the Cho'Cho.
Yeah, and that Cho'Gath is just going to get tankier and tankier. You know, about 1k, go 1.2k gold lead for Cho'Gath up in the top lane. And Hot S'mores, 300 gold lead. You know, Sylas is another 300 gold lead. So, and really, a lot of this gold has been funneled into Vayne. It feels like she has a lot of gold. You know, she's about 1k up on the Kai'Sa. But kind of crazy to see that, you know, just the amount of pressure that Fox Zero has. I mean, you look at that gold lead, that's 1300.
Yeah. I mean, that's absolutely massive. Compared to game one, a lot of things are playing into the favor of Reformed a lot better here, but that still doesn't leave out the fact that the teamfight presence from Redefy is still available. They just haven't quite been able to get in a spot where they can act all five members. I love the punishment in the Crimvale, though.
Yeah. I mean, you know, training back, you know, cute kitten, dodging all the abilities, no slouch in the mid lane. And now, you know, Crimvale's going to start to have hitting his abilities, hitting his Everfrost if he wants to ever think of getting a kill onto cute kitten. But, you know, Cho'Gath now 2-2 in the top lane, is still pushing that lane, does not care. We're going to see how much pressure he can exert. Has a pretty sizable gold lead. Oh my God.
Hard engage from Hot S'mores under the turret here with Flute Loops. Mind you, Egg Nevia is still up there. Teleport is canceled as Danny Phantom gets knocked up there from Adderall. It's only gone to go for the chase. And sadly, while they don't find the kill, they only find the passive. Still eats out a good flash to play around from Kitten.
Yeah, and Hot S'mores Ghost is going to be up sooner than, you know, Anivia's flash. So overall, right, you know, good trade on the side of summoner spells for Hot S'mores and Degeneracy Reformed as a whole. As this, you know, maybe next team fight's going to come up, they're dragging, they're timing this flash. So this flash won't be up for that Ocean Drake that's going to come up. And definitely the Ghost and the ultimate will be up on the side of Hecarim. So look to them to see play around that if they're timing this. As we see Foxio just bullying Kai'Sa. Oh, my.
Oh, wow. Look at Gon here. Good Chrono Break to prevent that one. But still, a lot of damage in the face of Crimvale there. And we haven't discussed it much, but Foxio is becoming a problem, man. And the fact that he's just been left to wander alone in that lane consistently and stack up this lead. We haven't even seen Fox play into a team fight this game yet.
Yeah.
The minute he groups up, it is going to be such a different look here for Reformed. And now, possibly a dive in the mid lane now.
Nah, it looks like they're just looking to exert some of their will and trying to get this mid turret damage down. I mean, it feels like right now it's kind of in a lull state. Degeneracy Reformed doesn't have a lot to do. They could not secure the poor Rift Herald. It is gone. Baron is up. King Baroni is coming into play, and we're going to see that going to be hopefully taken early.
We might see Crimvale first here. All four members of Redefy. I don't think there's even a contest. He throws out that Chrono Break, and the passive blows up here from Love, and he is low, but he still manages to find the response there. Crim, buddy, still far too deep. There's no reason to be on top of that blue. I mean, look at the ward advantage here.
Look at that top lane. That turret's looking pretty low. Oh man.
Man, you gotta feel so bad if you're Redefy. Every single time you go do anything productive for your team, Adderall is still pushing in your top.
Yeah.
And there it goes.
Tier 2 is gone. This man is on a mission. He's saying, I'm going to force you to respond to me. Now Cho'Gath's at that state where he is so tanky, right? With his health stacks, with the Merc Treads and the Everfrost, he's going to go back, probably get Oh yeah, the Bulwark, and he's gonna probably go for that Gargoyle Stone Plate as he ghosts out with his Summoner Spellbook.
He knows what he's doing. He's on his way. Oh my lord, he takes his actual route here towards a bit of mid lane. I'm curious to see if he's just gonna roam into the mid, actually. No, he's probably gonna start prepping for that Drake. 1 minute in here, he's gonna be the secure, stacks himself up another feast stack, so he's gonna be playing more towards the team for the next minute or so. So sadly, no top lane presence from Adderall for a little bit. Reify best easy, okay?
Yeah, but Adderall does have that teleport. I would love to see him actually. This is one of those cases where you want Adderall top lane because he has the TP advantage, right? I mean, you don't want to see him here. You don't want to go to drag and then TP up. You want to be at the top lane, push it in, force him to answer. And when you're safe, you can just TP bottom and look to join the fight. So
unless Adderall's not looking to rotate top anymore, maybe looking to play around this bot side. I could see
possibly,
that then.
Possibly gets the tier two, right?
Right.
He wants to be near the dragon. Maybe he won't have to burn the teleport.
Exactly.
He might be getting collapsed on, though. Danny Phantom and...
If Danny and Q-Kin think they can do anything to stop the force that is this Void Monster, it is not going to be enough. And so they have to back off, but they are going to get hard engaged. The fourth flash from Danny as Hot Swords still goes in around that wall there. Bit of an aggressive play, but they get a good knock up and silence onto what is Cute Kitten, forcing him lower and lower.
That's practically a kill, right? Even if they don't die, LF Cute Kitten at half, Kennen losing his flash, right? Such a key thing for his engage. And now Soul Point is going to be on 27 minutes now, right? 27 and a half minutes. So now they can threaten Soul Point. Ocean Soul, such a big thing for Degenerates Reformed if they can get it onto this Cho'Gath. He's just going to heal up. And Silas is going to be even more annoying with his Kingslayer passive healing plus Ocean Soul. I've been really, we need to start seeing some either grievous wounds on the side of Redefy, or they got to start contesting these dragons.
Absolutely. At this point, you're already on Soul Point, and while they did take the Infernal to slow it down just a bit, you're still sub 30 minutes for a massive contention that's going to be paying off, especially when Baron is constantly on the map as well here. So in terms of objective control, it has been a complete lock from Reform this game. And now, though, mid to late, we're starting to see those team fight groupings from the side of Redefy. This is where this team actually begins to shine. We haven't seen major contention around the Cosmic Radiance, around the Glacial Maelstrom, around some of those hard engagers with either the Killer Instinct or the Chrono Break on the belt of either Gon or Lovin. This is when we need to see them really put it down and say, okay, laning phase might not have went well, but we still have a lot to play around to get on top of guys like Fox or Crimvale and shut down these team fights.
Yeah, but the gold lead has slowly been creeping in the flavor town, you know,
of Degenerates. What kind of flavor is Degenerates Reform? Just let me know. I'm curious.
If I were to say anything, they're probably the epitome of Rocky Road.
Oh, so we're going ice cream. I'll take
it. Oh, I mean, so when I think of flavors, I think of ice cream.
I thought of wings.
speaking of habanero, is
wings. Lute's looking to wing it as he goes in for that hard knock of Crim goes back in. Cosmic Radiance is down there to prevent anyone from getting killed as Crimgale gets punished this one out. The team continues to collapse with a good first knockups gets on. Fox here is able to kite this one out, flashes back, can't quite find love, but he eventually gets the tumble into the double there. Turns his attention to Gon, but he's slowed out as Cute has thrown down the Glacial Slows. Woo! It's 2-for-2 in response to the hard engage there. That's what I wanted to see, though, from Redefy. That's the team fight presence.
But that was a 4v5. You have to realize Adderall wasn't even there. And just the expert kiting from Fox Zero. I don't know if you saw him, but he queued flashback Eid and got the condemn off on to, I believe, LSD Love, was it? And just got that kill. Really clean vein mechanics. Unfortunately, that Crimvale couldn't get a lot of the damage off, but that was a 4v5. Cho'Gath wasn't in that fight. Cho'Gath wasn't there to be annoying. Wasn't there to knock people up and silence them. But a really good ultimate by Lemon Soda, really well played. Nobody, you know, died in that initial hard engage like you mentioned. But you know, these fights are pretty much neck and neck. This gold lead, look, it's about, you know, 4.5k, but it doesn't, like the last game, it doesn't feel like it, right? These teams are 6-6. You have to believe that Redefy Esports doesn't feel like they're that far behind and they're willing to take these fights, and that's what you want to see. This is a 5v5 team comp, right? It's Kennen, it's Echo, it's Kai'Sa, it's Anivia. There's all these characters that do AoE damage. As Flute Loops is gonna die here.
Yeah, Flute Loops caught through, gets walled out, can't find the escape. Does one pump back into Love before he walks out of that one, but sadly he is taken through, and that's one heavy frontline to be down in the face of major objective control. And Hot Spores might be next here, playing aggressive again into the side. God. No response, taken out. Love gets the red buff as a result on the trade there. That's two major members down now for the side of Degenerates Reform. This could be a stacking Baron play here.
Yeah, it could be. And really, I don't understand what Degenerates Reformed is doing, trying to secure vision in the jungle right now. I mean, you have the inline onto the Baron. You don't need to.
Huge ult.
Oh, yeah. Uh-oh, but Cho'Gath can flash consume this.
He can try to go for it, but I think Lemon Soda's got that in mind. No, don't step into it too far. I want to see you dazzle the Cho. No, actually, Cho doesn't care. He could care less about this deal. They want to put their attention towards the Drake probably here in 1 minute, and they don't want to put themselves into a poor position by going for something aggressive like that, so they give up the Baron.
Yeah, ping's coming out onto the Dragon on the side of Redefy Esports. Now, Degenerates Reform does have the inside track. They do have the vision. They are still up a couple thousand gold. Baron not giving too many combat stats. It's more of a pushing orientated buff. So we'll see if they can, you know, really look to exert their pressure on this Baron. You know, Redefy, you know, has been known to face check on Degenerates Reform. Degenerates Reform really likes to, you know, camp these bushes. We saw them do it multiple times last game. They might look to use this vision denial against Redefy and force them to kind of face check in to this Alistar, this Cho'Gath. This Cho'Gath is coming in with the flank, but Danny Phantom's also trying to flank.
Oh, look at this death brush. They've already found it. There's a steal on the hijack, and now add all the point of focus here as the rest of the team goes for that hard engage. Lemon Soda immediately responds with the Cosmic Radiance, but it's nothing to play around as a response with the Onslaught Shadows from Hot S'mores goes deep into this backline, but Flute Loops is caught out and taken through by Love now, but there's
huge
the response
rupture
from Hog Zero. Good rupture, like I said, for Adult pushing up. Now Fox here on the hunt with the final hour, steps up, finds the shutdown when he needs to onto LSD Love, turns his attention, gets it on top of him for a triple, now onto Q. Kitten, both Phantom gone, retreating as they can, and that's going to be what is the Ocean Soul now here for Degenerates Reformed.
And it looked like it was a bad start from Crimvale. He took Terex ult and immediately popped it, but they were too far away to really get any use out of it. The disengage that they did after that Terek ultimate from Lemon Soda, just backing off, waiting it out, getting the re-engage on with Hecarim's ultimate. That was beautiful. Was able to fear them on the last 0.5 seconds of their invulnerability. Weren't able to really do much. And that rupture from Adderall was so huge.
Setup.
Right? Three-man rupture into the silence. And it just felt like, you know, Redefy Esports couldn't get a lot of their cooldowns off, couldn't get a lot of their, you know, abilities and DPS off. And Foxio free hitting whatever is in front of them, and she's at this point now. Vayne will just 2 to 3 shot anybody. Doesn't matter if you're Carrick, doesn't matter if you're Nivea, Echo, doesn't matter. She has the Kraken Slayer, she has the IE, the PD, and now she even has a QSS, even that much harder to lock down.
Absolutely. So at this point, 5-0, and it was funny because Love comes out of that Baron fight looking just as good on this Kai'Sa, and we're starting to think of, wow, getting the scaling up, the potential, it's going to really work into this comp. But Fox is just there on the return and goes back to that kind of marquee matchup in the bot lane. Love versus Fox, at the end of the day, your micro skill presence from Fox takes this matchup time and time again. But now in the top lane, Crimvale going to be hard engaged on, going to be using that Chrono Break, because Boot Loops is there for the response, but Lemon Soda is there on the back line. Good triple knockup, but it's straight into the Glacial Maelstrom, finds that kill onto Danny Phantom as a teleport. He's coming through from Adderall there. They get the knockup on the Lemon Soda, but
Vayne's
the response is Q is down as well. Lemon Soda's going to throw the Cosmic Radiance when needs be, but Fox here finally rises as Fluke goes down. Finds the immediate kill response, though, on the Danim Phantom, but they can't push any further due to a great Glacial Storm there from Cute Kitten.
Crimvale getting caught out. I feel like we've seen this multiple times. Oh my god, Hotsmore is just going in.
Yeah, absolutely. Can't find quite what he needs to as the wall prevents the rest of the team. And that Cute Kitten slow with the wall has actually dissuaded most team fights compared to any other damage or lockdown that Redefy has put down.
I mean, we know why it's a comfort pick for this person. A lot of games on this Nivea really knows how to pilot this champion, like you mentioned. But honestly, the mistake on Degenerates is just fighting without their Vayne. I mean, she's the one that's carrying them. It feels like Crimvale is constantly getting caught out as he TPs into the bot lane looking to get this tier 2 in the bot lane. It's not Adderall this time, but it's Crimvale.
It's fine by me. Take it anyways. Either way, they'll find that one for themselves, kind of make up for a little bit of loss on the top side. But I agree with you. Crimvale, you're caught out by the blue buff to an originate. You're on the top side getting caught out. These are some major losses for your team here. And And it's really what dissuades from them going in as a whole, because both comps want to go for the 5v5. They both want to play into each other. Unless, of course, Adderall is, you know, top yapping. But either way, on the side, constantly, if you're going down before the fight even begins, before Fox is even there to respond, what does this mean for your comps, win con as a whole? Nothing. And Krim's here on the side on blue again, and this time he doesn't get caught out.
I mean, he gets the blue. Calling Worth every time. Hotsmores doesn't want to give the blue away to Krimvale. It's like, this is my blue, this is my jungle. You're not allowed to have it. You keep getting caught out, buddy. But I want to tarp on a little bit, you know, I don't not harp on, I want to talk about the excellent itemization from Hotsmores, recognizing that a lot of the damage is, of course, you know, magic damage. They build a lot of AP, so they go for that Force of Nature and also going for that Spirit Visage just to get a little bit more healing. And Spirit Visage synergizes so well with the Ocean Soul, right? Amplifies healing that much more. I don't feel like this Hecarim is going to die. He could literally just ulti into a five-man fountain and still come out alive, I feel like.
Right, and that's what enables Hotsmores to play as aggressively as he does. The thing is, we just need to see the consistent follow-up from guys like Krim and Fox here, and that hasn't really come to full fruition yet. One good grouping, though, and I feel like it's all over for Redefy. So we'll have to wait and see, because honestly, Redefy is definitely putting pedal to the metal. They're playing this one out efficiently. They're getting those picks when they need to. They've set up for Baron once, and they probably could do it again.
I mean, Regenerous Reformed is going to get the vision out. They're clearing out a lot of the red side vision that is on there. Oh, as Alistar is just playing so aggressively so far up. And I really like seeing Alistars play this way. I don't like them playing a little scared. I want them to be like, you know, the follow-up or even the main engage. But Degenerous Reformed has the Baron. They're probably going to look towards it. They can burn it down very quickly with this Vayne, and they can secure it pretty easily. It will be an almost like a 1700 secure with Cho'Gath Smite doing 1k, and I believe this Smite is about at the 700 to 800 Smite damage range. They know this Baron's being taken, but what can Redefy really do, Zephyr?
I don't know. It's going to have to be one excellent steal, hopefully, but either way, it's going to be hard playing into Adderall with that Beastax Limit Soda over the wall, and they get the steal with the Smite! They find the stun on top of it! It's going to be a punishment on top of Lemon Soda, but does it even matter there?
Oh man.
My god!
Not timing the execute with the Cho Smite is just something that even bronze players can do, Zephyr. They understand that they need to R with Cho'Gath and then smite with Hecarim or vice versa. Come on, man. It's 1800. This Echo should not be able to steal it, guys.
Either way, Reform's still pushing in. It might be a Baron buff into the response here, but they still hold hard aggression as they continue this wave's push. It's going to be cleared out, of course. You've got Cute Kitten sitting on that Nivea. There's no way they can hard push, especially now in the face of these super minions, but...
Elder God. Are they going to lose this Elder to MB gone as well? I mean, come on, guys. Smite, execute. Smite, R, guys. That's all you got to do. Oh, now, as you see Cho'Gath.
10 seconds, yeah, Cho'Gath is slowed out there. They could look for Krimvale here on the side, but Krimvale goes back and gets a slow. Me response, Glacial Maelstrom to play off of this one, but the damage is still there before he goes down. Fox on the side, Fox into Lelis. Love absolutely destroys and shreds. Now Cute Kitten, the only one left through in this mid lane, also taken out by the Madman. That is Fox Zero. Four members gone, nobody with Baron buff now. They can rotate this down to mid. They can take Elder. They can do whatever they want.
The world is their oyster, man. They can do whatever they want. They're going to look for the mid inhib. I honestly think they could have gone for the end if they committed all four. It's only Taric up, but it looks like they want to secure the dub. They want to secure the victory as best as they can, going for the Elder. But I feel like this is a macro mishap. They could go for this. They have a lot of pushing power with the Bane.
Fox is so aggressive, he's even taking it under turret to them. But they do get inhib, and more than likely they're going to pull back here, Shibi. But hey, it's an Elder to play around two now, though. And if we're going to talk about teamfight presence to go for kill feeds, I still think it plays in favor even more so now for Jaren's Reform. How do you play into the Elder?
Your best bet is just try to wait it out. Maybe look for a pick onto this Krimvale that has constantly been getting caught out. TPs are committed into the bot lane. I don't know what Kennen's...
The TP you want to expend there, Phantom. He is launched out. Hotsmores doesn't find the engage he wants, but that looked a bit daunting and risky. But that's no TP for Phantom now.
Yeah, and the TP was burned on the side of LFQ Kitten as well, so both TPs are down. Cho'Gath has his summoner spell up from the unsealed spell with the heal. Probably going to use it to get the TP back up. Krimbell also has the TP. It feels like they can just go for a 1-4 composition right now with Cho'Gath splitting in the top lane or even Krimbell splitting in the top lane. Either of them can group. They could potentially go for a 1-3-1, but I think it's a little too weak. They don't have as much peel. I feel like Adderall has been doing a fantastic job with these ruptures and these silences, just disrupting the spell singing combination of Echo and Anivia and Kai'Sa, and really disrupting their DPS timings, which is, silence is something you don't really think of as very, you know, game changing until it comes to like coordinated play, where, you know, a lot of this is, you know, we need to time this with this as we see some action.
Floop pops it back into Foxer there. Glacial Maelstrom thrown out pretty early. That's going to be a bit of a wash here for further teamfights, but Floop is taken low there. Almost out as a whole, but Krimbell there with the swaps of Helper coming in there. Love gets the slay, but stop before Krimbell comes on the side, taking out Love. That's your major carry. Good charm into the back, but they don't quite find the stun. Is gone, is taken out from a killing spree from Adderall. Now he steps forward, the massive Void Monster himself, as he goes for Danny Phantom, finds the Rupture, and eats him all up. Gobble, gobble now, Cute Kitten. The only one left alive here for the side of Redefy Unleashed. That's all but over here. Under turret they go, fear him back. Easy kill picked up again for Adderall into the face of an ace. And now, in a bit more of a clean fashion, Degenerates Reform take game two.
And looks like my prediction may be coming true, Zephyr.
Shut up.
The 3-0.
That was the sigh there at the end.
I believe Degenerates Reform. You know what? They played very clean this game. They got the right people ahead. I mean, really, what is Redefy doing? Letting Fox Zero just free farm on the Vayne. I get it. If it's a Varus, if it's a Sivir, if it's something else. But man, this guy is known to carry. You have to respect your opponent. I don't know if it's an ego thing from LSD Love and Levin Soda, if they don't need the attention bot lane, but man, Fox Zero posting up an impressive 7-0-5 scoreline. And really the unsung hero of this game, I think, is Adderall. That guy played exceptionally well.
Unsung. We're about to sing it as loud as we can. Adderall was phenomenal on top of the show, and this was a different read from the York. York, of course, wants to sit on that side lane and continue pressuring the advantage. This time around, Adderall, teamfight focus was on top, complete split push presence was there when it needed to, and just the absolute front that allowed guys like Krimvile and Fox Zero to play around this team comp was there. You know, Adderall through and through absolutely dominated the competition here from the side of Redefy.
Yeah, and really, it felt like Krimvile was getting caught out quite a bit, but was really stealing crucial ultimates, stalling for his team, right, with the Echo ultimate. You know, it looked like he was getting caught out, and then, you know, he would stall. Adderall would show up. Hot S'mores would show up, ghosting in like the pony, and then Fox Zero would show up for the cleanup. You know, and getting these amazing engages, stealing cannons, all, you know, getting these 3-4 man slicing maelstroms, it just felt that whatever Redefy was doing, Degenerate was just doing slightly better. I mean, they have Silas, they have the Cho'Gath. So now, where do you look to if you're down 2-0 on Redefy's side? What do you ban? What do you give away? It feels like Adderall, you know, is just so threatening on two of his main top champions. Do you look at the top lane? Do you maybe look at the bot lane? I mean, you took one of the better, you know, AD carries this meta, Kai'Sa being one of the top three, you know, best AD carries, in my opinion, in the competitive scene right now in the meta. But Fox Zero still being able to perform in the Vayne. Like, where do you look to?
At this point, the pull here from the side of Reform is too difficult to match into. You got to get rid of the strengths, right? So I think the Thresh bans, the Yorick bans into the Tristana, that still is working for them. Those are some of the hot picks here for Redefy. What you now need to do, though, for Redefy is secure what works for your team here. I've yet to see a really strong pick for Cute Kitten, and while Love looked good this game, it was far more intense from the side of what was Vayne. I need to see consistent rotations from Gon playing off something even more aggressive. The Echo was good, but it wasn't as intense as we had seen into semifinals. That's when that guy was absolutely just popping off on that champion, and that needs to come back around. Dan needs to kind of play it and up the ante for the weak side top lane if he is going to be rushing into the monster that is Adderall. You know, need excellent caliber from this 2v2 matchup on that mid jungle here for Redefy, or else it's all but over, because personally, bot lane's already in the bag for Reform. You've got to start playing around some of the weaker sides from S'mores and Krimbell. That's where you kind of eep into this. That's your shoehorn to get your foot through the door.
Yeah, I think Redefy just needs to play. It looks like they're playing for a little bit of comfort, right, on what they want to play, but it's not working. I think they just need to pick better meta champions, in my opinion, right? Get Q-Kitten on something like the Orianna. It was playing really well in game one. I mean, you have to chalk game one up to, like, just a misplay, right? You have to look at those champions. You have to look at what gave you a lot of success. It wasn't, you know, a comp diff. It was just a macros, a brain diff a little bit on that game one. So maybe going back to the Orianna, going back to the Volibear, I think is very important. I think you can give up Cho'Gath in favor for you just banning this Thresh and banning the Yorick out. But I really want to see stronger meta picks. I didn't like the Taric. Taric got really nerfed. He had some good, Cosmic Radiances, but was just able to be played around too easily. I think that's the issue. Would have loved to see Lemon Soda go for something more aggressive. You know, possibly the Leona. You know, you can even see the Lulu if you want to pair it up with this Kai'Sa. I feel like Taric just, you know, I get the idea, but you need to have more than that to play around hard engage, right? Because they had so many different engage tools with the Alistar, with the Cho'Gath Rupture, with the Hecarim Ultimate, and even, you know, they forgot about really Sylas being able to steal a hard engage on their side and just be able to use it against them. So we'll have to see more stronger meta picks on the side of Degenerates, right, on the side of Redefy, not Degenerates.
Right. Either way, it's going to be left up to the draft that we'll be getting into here shortly. We're going to be going towards a short break as we get that all wrapped up, headed your way. So stick around and stay tuned for what could possibly be the clean full 3-0 here from Degenerates Reformed.